Right, let me adjust my video and other things. Let me start to share my slides. Just give me a moment.
Yeah, take your time. Sometimes due to connectivity or some other reason, it takes a little while more. We would wait. We are keen to hear you. It's been very exciting and knowledgeable session today so far. Lot of things which some of us would not be knowing, would not be updated about the latest technologies, probably must have come to know, and might see how we can implement it in the future projects.
Just hang on.
Yes. I can see your screen now. Over to you.
Okay. Now the challenge here is I need to use the computer audio. Siddharth, could you tell me again how to
do that? I can hear you. Your screen is visible. You may start.
Okay. No, I have got a couple of videos that comes with the audio as well. So how do I share?
Mr. Murthy, you have to, while sharing the screen, there is a tick box at the bottom left where you have to just tick share your computer audio. While sharing, you have to just tick that box.
Let me do one more time.
Did you tick that box of share computer?
Which screen again?
You have to stop the screen share once and then you have to do it.
Okay, now I go to share.
Yeah, there is a bottom left tick box option.
Bottom left.
Share computer sound.
Right. Can you, you guys can see the video? The slides?
Yes, slide is visible.
All right.
Yes.
All right, that's good. Let's go ahead then. All right, guys, good evening. Let me quickly start on my content. I'm going to share a story of there's a quantum leap jump of prefabrication adoption in Singapore for the last 6 years, how the whole industry is completely transformed from conventional construction to prefabrication construction. Okay, just a quick background on my company. I belong to ARC. We have a core business, just this one slide of sharing. We have an engineering consultancy, particularly for modular construction, so-called, we call it as a DFME. And we have a global network of supplier connection as well. So, and we have a strong digital arm as well. We have a one proprietary construction management software, and we do a integrated digital delivery for construction projects. Quite a lot of projects we have in Singapore as well as Southeast Asia. All right. Just quick look on how Singapore has moved forward from 2014 until 2020. In 2017, within 3 years, 20% of our buildings are switched to prefabrication methods. And we are in 2020. At the moment, we have about 40% of building construction, including of our tall building constructions, are switched to prefabrication. And moving forward, we are targeting about 70% of our buildings are to be in prefabrication construction. That's the target. And if you look at the global statistics in the world, although Singapore is a smaller nation in the world, we have most number of off-site construction, so-called DFMA construction projects in Singapore. If you visit after COVID period, you look at the most of our construction projects are going with the prefabrication construction, particularly in a volumetric way of construction. Okay, I have two parts to share in this presentation. because it's only time is limited. DFMA has got wide range, but I was limited to share only on the volumetric construction. So I'm going to limit my presentation to PBU, which is called, in India context, they would call it as a bathroom pots, but in Singapore, we call it as a PBU. In PBU, it's not new to Singapore. We have been using it since 2007. At the moment, in all building construction, the bathroom must be built by a PBU. That means it's quite norm. But there are three ways of common method of PBUs we have in Singapore, which is either it's a normal concrete or lightweight concrete or a drywall. This is the most common method of. Why do we switch to normal bathroom construction to PBU? There's a few simple reasons. So one is, although toilet is a smaller element, you have 13 trays inside the toilet. Start from waterproofing, screening, tiling, false ceiling, cabinet, shower screen. You count, it will be exactly about 13 to 14 trays. That trays takes a lot of manpower, right? That is the reason if you do it at the factory, you have a better productivity impact and speed in construction, you would see. Then statistically, we have a track record of it saves about 40% manpower reduction and at least about 20% of faster construction, which is proven in Singapore. Okay, that's about that normal concrete PBU, which Alexander explained. This is a very monolithic way of doing it. Of course, you need to cast in reversely. The first one is the mold. Then after casting, you will do all the trade works at site, including of tiling and false ceiling and everything. After it will be transported to site. Again, it will be lifted, then installed at the site. But this PBU will be installed in a critical path method. It can't be go by the push-in method because the weight is 5 to 6 tons, right? The next type of a PBU, which is lightweight concrete PBU, which is again, is the concrete density is only 700 kg per meter cube compared to 2400, which is in the previous version. Here, the wall thickness is 50 mm only. This is again, is a non-load bearing element. In Singapore context, that bathroom parts mostly they use as a non-load bearing element. There are reasons for that, which I could answer during that Q&A session. And all the MEP concealed services, they provide recess because the wall thickness is only 50 mm. And advantage of this method is it can go by the non-critical path method. When you go for non-critical path method, you would have you can complete many trades, and the trade works are protected because it's a six-sided PBU. Okay, I have a video, short video, 1 minute video. In our precast from PBU factory, which how they produced precast and PBU, which is quite different from open precast yard factory, which is automated. Let me show the video.
Welcome to Grayform. The production begins with the ordering and arrival of specified raw material. Our fully automated processes means relatively fewer personnel are required to manage the factory floors. The controlled environment ensures both greater safety and far higher productivity than traditionally practiced at every juncture. Automation also translates into greater resource efficiency, meaning swifter and more affordable solutions. Resulting products are fully customizable, completely uniform, and have consistently installed the requisite fittings and finishings precisely as specified. Finished units are packaged securely and then stored, ready for dispatching to construction sites in the sequence required.
Kishan, is my videos are audible?
Yes, it was absolutely audible.
Okay, that's great. Okay, let me move on to the next one. It's a drywall pod, which is also quite common in Singapore. The advantage is it's a lighter, but the other hand, the limitation is it's like a concrete pod. You can do hacking after completion of the PBU. You can do multiple kind of renovation, but this is a bit limited. But other advantage is it's faster compared to that your concrete pods. The biggest advantage is only 3 ton. It can go very well by non-critical path installations. I have a video to show that. This video was taken in the US, but in Singapore, we have a couple of factories exactly doing the same kind of method of production in Singapore, but that video's qualities are not so good. So I use that US video, but nothing different from that in terms of process-wise. Let me click on the video. I'm sorry. To the point of final slide for the PBU is many of you have a question on what is critical path and a non-critical path. I don't want to go into too much of engineering point, but just briefly highlight critical path is suitable for a concrete type of a PBU because you can't do a cushion method. But again, you need to have a base slab. When you install it, it's open to weather. So the protection is a big challenge if you do it a six-sided PBU, and the coordination and alignment is a bit tricky or critical, but it can be manageable. But on the other hand, non-critical path elements, you know, it doesn't bother about your structural work progress. You can complete your structural works of the buildings, but using of cantilever platform, you can use a cushion trolley to push the PBU, which works of the more on the non-concrete types of PBU. For example, like lightweight concrete or ferrous cement, or like a drywall PBU. That kind of the advantage of this non-critical path method is it doesn't affect your structural works. And on top of that, it can be completed with a six-sided PBU, and you can include more finishes. You can see the picture here. You can include your toilet bowl and shower screen, and a complete fit out can be done on this method. That is a short differentiation of critical path and non-critical path installation of pipes. Okay, beside this kind of PBU, we do have the latest development, which we are going to use it by next year, this kind of 3D type of PBU, which was developed by one of the Singapore company together with the Nanyang Technological University. It's going to be commissioned by next year for the actual project. Let me show the quick video of how the bathrooms can be completed by the 3D printing methodology. We'll be right back. Okay, the next topic, I quickly move on to that volumetric construction. It's called volumetric modular construction, but in Singapore, we call it as a prefabricated, pre-finished volumetric construction. The reason being is when the module comes on site, all the finishes, including of MEP fittings, must be installed at the factory. That's called, it's called PPVC, and I know it's a bit complicated to pronounce. All right, so there are quite a number of projects completed in Singapore. At the moment, if I'm not wrong, around 60 projects are ongoing, all are tall building. About 10 projects have been completed. This technology, again, we started in 2014, and going forward, most of the high-rise building, particularly for residential hotel projects, will be completed or constructed by using of this full volumetric method. The key difference between the bathroom parts and the volumetric construction, this PPVC, is this is a structural element. This is the projects done in last year. It's a 40-story residential apartment, consists of 515 units. I was heavily involved for the design and construction of for this project. It completed about 6 months earlier than the schedule. That is the speed. This is the actual project. Rather than showing the slide, let me show the actual site video, how the modules are completed. The next one I'm going to show, before we started this technology in Singapore, we went to worldwide and through with the Singapore government authority and our engineers and architects went to study from worldwide. We picked up for this project 2014. It was the tallest tower in New York City, a 32-story built in a modular construction, volumetric modular construction. We learned the techniques and we modified that engineering technology because this project was built in steel, but in Singapore context, we Asian prefer concrete structure. So in 2018, we completed 40-story projects. Then what happened is right now is ongoing projects using of this volumetric construction. Now we are building it 56-story. Which is under construction now using of volumetric construction. All right, I can show a little bit of the progress of these projects and how we design as a modular construction. When the architect have a layout, it will be prepared for a modular construction. It's not all that elements are modular, only 65% of the superstructures are modular. For engineering wise, you need to have a, because of lateral stability, you need to have a core, so the lift core wall, and you have a staircase using to tie to the modular. And this is another 3D view. You can see that the center portions are cast in situ. Right, so this is how that each apartment can be sliced into a module. Each modules when you put together, and how do you join? That's where our engineering, all the details are. Devil is in the detail, so that the engineering details are comes, how do we join the module and behave like a monolithic way, right? And this is the actual shell. There are two type of volumetric modular construction. One is shear wall, one is a frame structure. What I'm going to show, what I'm showing is the shear wall kind of a modular construction, right? Then once the modules are casted at the factory precast yard, it will be bring to the fit out yard. That fit out are like a car factory assembly. I will show the exact photographs of the fit out yard. This is the fit out yard where you will have all the trades works and MEP works will be completed in this factory before bringing to site. Again, this is the actual projects. Then the modules are delivered to, by trailers and lifting by the high capacity tower crane. you see the things as a 40-story projects. I'm not exaggerating this point, that the tolerance for these modules, this is a heavy modules like 30 to 35 tons. The tolerance for these modules is a 2 mm exactly. I'm again repeating 2 mm tolerance, which that kind of precision we would never ever achieve in conventional construction. That is the beauty of this technology. But of course, before that, we need to do a lot of engineering works. Okay, my last part is on art services. Beside our engineering services, what we do is all these DFMA project or volumetric modular construction projects are managed by our construction management software, which is our very own patent system, LiveBeam. You can see that a live progress of construction modules, how it's being delivered, how it's being installed, how many modules are installed, what is the progress, delivery, tracking, everything is digitally managed, right? Besides the technology, engineering technology. Right. Coming back, okay, the one common question people would have is how do we manage quality in volumetric modular construction? The things are produced at the factory, when it install on site, how do the coordination is managed? In Singapore, all the volumetric modular system need to be approved by the various government agencies. There is approval checklist. There is a stringent quality criteria is there. Then all the modules construction must comply with that, particularly for the building code and the including of seismic code. So we have a standards and checklist and everything, which I can answer it up during your Q&A system. All right. What happened is the last six years, the transformation of the industry is quite drastic. You know, most of our main builders, so-called general contractors, have set up that volumetric modular construction arm, so-called as a prefabrication arm, so that they are drastically moving towards this method of construction, because there is a proven track record or proven benefit on the improving of speed, productivity, and quality. Of course, the cost is there, but cost is still manageable. But at the moment, the cost is neutral. That means cost neutral means it's almost the same level of conventional construction if you offset all your labor saving and speed. All right, I bring back to my last slides on the art services. We have engineering arms, which is to take care of our modular construction solution designs, and we have our digital arm. And this is my email ID. If audience have got any personal questions, you can drop me an email. I'm happy to answer for it. That's all. I have seen quite a number of questions, but I would like to pick up one engineering questions and one very general commercial questions. How would that lift core wall will be constructed when it PPVC construction? As I mentioned during that my presentation, only that apartment modules are constructed by the volumetric modular construction. Lift core wall gives a lateral stability. It must be constructed by that either cost in situ or by the precast method, panel method. Again, there is a tie rebars from the lift core wall, which will be tied to that modular, that volumetric modules. In short answer, the lift core wall is not the lift core module is not a volumetric construction. It's either precast or conventional. The second question is PPVC is possible in India? Why not? Everywhere, anywhere. So then the question, the subdivision is whether can it be complied to the Indian codes? Yes, we did a thorough analysis on that one. In Singapore, predominantly, we use a Euro code, but we did a best comparison of how is the Euro code and the Indian codes. Yes, PPVC is complying to the Indian codes. In engineering wise, it behaves as the same way as a column and frame methods, where the loads are transferred, or by the shear wall design. This is the two method only. So it can comply to the codes. It shouldn't be a problem. Yeah, that is a...